Vi skal begynne igjen med del 2. Jeg tror det er viktig å se også at Jesus er det ok å spise gratis mat. Det var bare en poeng at med Warzone Disciples på Vestborg, vi begynner med motiv. Hvorfor er du her? Er det bare Jesus? Så de kom en møte, neste møte, neste møte. Vi var ferdige, vi har litt go-kart sammen. Det koster mye penger, men det er en fantastisk tid. Også litt pizza sammen. Så vi bare snakker om motiv. Hvorfor er vi her? Hvorfor er det mulig at... Hvorfor skal jeg bli i kirke neste søndag? Hvorfor skal jeg komme til Logos? Hva er største motiv? Husk siste bildet. Tro på Jesus er en tro på historisk fakta om han. Atheister også er enig. Jesus was real. Ikke spøkelse or a myth. A real man who lived and died and rose again from the grave. Vi bare snakket om en vers i Johannes første brev. Bare en vers. Det er så, Guds ord er så dyp. Det er ikke kjedelig. Det er fantastisk. Det er samme som norsk olje. Norwegian oil. Many years ago, somebody said to the Norwegians, oh, there's some oil there, maybe. And Norway started to dig into this oil and found that the oil wasn't just this much, but the oil was almost endless oil. And that's why Norway has become one of the richest countries in the world, because the deeper they went, the richer they became. You live in a world which is always going to encourage you not to go deep. Don't go deep. TikTok, social media, it's not encouraging you to go deep. It's encouraging you surface. And again, it will track your thinking. It will grab hold of your thinking and allow you to think you're in control. But in reality, social media is in control. And you've become an addict who doesn't think deeply. But I would encourage you to start to find out how to think deeply with God's word. To dig down deep. Not the whole book. Maybe just choose one book, Johannes first brev, or one chapter, or one psalm, and say, I'm going to check this psalm out for the next 3 months and go deep. And I guarantee you, Gud vil snakke til dere. Ganske stark. Og du vil tenke, oi, denne ord her, det er levende. Is that not right? It's alive. It lives. And it lives in me. God wants his word to live in you. Verse 2. Og livet blir åpenbart. Det er viktig ord. Jeg har snakket om det allerede. Åpenbart. Ikke bare informasjon. Åpenbart. Og vi har sett det og vitnet om forkynnet det livet som var hos Faderen og ble åpenbart for oss. Revelation, ikke bare information. I English, it goes quite well. Så spørsmål til dere. Is Jesus revelation or just information? I've said already, it's quite easy. How do I know if Jesus is just information? If all I've ever received from church, information Jesus, kjedelig, møte, kjedelig, følg Jesus, kjedelig, kirke søndag, kjedelig. Men hvis jeg har åpenbaring fra Gud, Guds ord er viktig, bønn er viktig, møte er viktig. Kirkesøndag er viktig. I say to people, if God is openbaring, if he's revelation to us, church on a Sunday is our match day. Have you heard like football fans? Come Saturday, match day, especially in England. They get so excited by match day, they'll start talking about the game on Saturday, on Tuesday. And then on Thursday, they plan to meet together so that they can arrange where they're going to meet for Saturday. And what they're going to wear for Saturday. And then when it comes to Saturday, match day, even before it, they get into the stadium early and start singing songs without anybody telling them to sing songs. Why? They love their football club. They love their football. And then when it's match time, they're loving it. There's no TikTok. There's no mobile phone. They're watching the game. They're watching the players. They're watching their team. And if their team wins or loses, some of them at the end still sing at the end. They sing their songs of their team. And everybody else has left, and they're still there singing. Wofür? They love their team. Oh, and we need God to shake us up and wake us up again so that we will be people that follow him and are like, I'm going to church Sunday. Why? It's my match day. There's preaching, there's worship, it's about God, it's his people, I'm going. It's match day. Men før du tenkte at kirke var så kjedelig, ja, men Jesus var bare informasjon til deg, men nå han har åpenbaring til meg. Kirke søndag, match day. Men det bare gammel folk i kirke søndag. Men det Gud også. I'm going, match day. Forstår dere? Revelation, ikke bare informasjon. I Matteus 16, vers 15-17. Vers 15. Han sier til dem, men dere, hvem dere sier at jeg er? Just before that, Jesus spoke to a group of people just like you. He took them away from the busyness of life. Some of you have come from Trigheim. You're having a bit of a time out. Jesus took his disciples away from the busyness and he wanted to ask them a question. First question, who do people say that I am? Some say you're Jeremiah, some say you're Elijah, some say you're one of the prophets. But that wasn't the question Jesus was going after. He turns to his disciples and then he says to them, who do you say I am? If you had the opportunity to come up here tonight and just say who Jesus is, who would you say he is? Da svarte Simon Peter og sa, du Messiah, den levende Guds sønn. Ikke bare menneske, men Gud også. Samme Gud som har skapt alt sammen. Menneske, Gud, Jesus. Jeg tror på han. Jesus svarte han og sa, salig er du, Simon Peter. Blessed are you. For det er ikke kjøtt og blod, informasjon, som har åpenbart dette for deg, men min far i himmelen, åndelig åpenbaring til hjerte og hjerne og hvem Jesus er. Du er Guds sønn, Jesus. Jeg forstår hvem du er. Du er så viktig til meg. Og Johannes 5, 25. Det er fantastiske vers. Jeg elsker det. Johannes 5, 25. Sannelig, sannelig, ser jeg dere. Den time kommer, og den er nå. Da de døde skal høre Guds sønns røst, og de som hører skal leve. Sannelig, sannelig, sier jeg dere, den time kommer og den er nå, da de døde skal høre Guds sønns røst, og de som hører skal leve. Jeg skal gå litt videre til her. Spørsmål. Reflektive spørsmål. Ikke gi svar, bare tenk. Hvor får du gleden fra i dag? Tenk om det. Ikke vanlig gleden, åndelig gleden. Today, where have you got your spiritual joy from today? And then you'll start to know in your mind, in your own mind, I'm not judging you. You'll start to work out your priorities in life. Because I'm getting my joy from this. And you hold that thing right up. And if that thing is not Jesus and salvation, It's an idol that you worship instead of Jesus. And before I was saved, before I knew God, I worshipped football. I wanted to play football so well so that everyone could look at me and say, hey, you're brilliant at football. That's why I played football. I didn't play football for enjoyment. I played it so people could look at me and tell me I was great. So where have you got your joy from today? And wherever that thing is, if it's not Christ and if it's not salvation, that's an idol. That's what you love most. And you have to take a bit of time to just go to God and say, God, help me. Hjelp meg. Fordi jeg har lys at Jesus er nummer en. The day after I became a Christian and the next football match that I played, I enjoyed that football game more than any other football game I'd ever played. Hvorfor? Because now I was just playing football for fun and enjoyment. Before, had to win. If you didn't win, you can't enjoy it. But with God in your heart and your mind, suddenly all these things, they become enjoyable. I can enjoy sports. I can enjoy my education. Vestborg students don't believe me, but I said, when God's in your heart and your mind, you can go into your maths exam and love it. As an adventure. Not as stress, not as worry. But God, I'm going to do my best, but I'm doing my best for you. I'm going to play my football, but I'm playing my football for you. I don't care if people look at me. I don't need to be looked at. I don't need affirmation. I'm not chasing after likes. I'll just do it for you, God. I'll do my education for you. I'll be in relationships for you. I'll play my football for you. I don't need people to check me out. Nehemiah 8:10, for gleden i Herren deres styrke. Men åndens frukt kjærlighet, glede, fred, åpenbarhet, vennlighet, godhet, trofasthet, ydmykhet og selvbeherskelse, self-control, discipline. Slik ting rammes ikke av loven. Må håpets Gud fylle dere med alle glede og fred i troen, så dere kan bli rik på håp ved den hellige ånds kraft. The Christian life is to be lived in the power and the strength of the Holy Spirit. Not in my own strength. Vi skal gå litt videre, fordi det er viktig spørsmålet også. Hvordan kan vi vite om vi er frelst? I 2 Korinther brev 13:5, there's a test that you can do. You might be here going, well, I just don't know if I'm saved. There's a test in the Bible that can let you know for sure, even tonight, if you're saved or if you're not saved. And it's a great thing to know. Like, you need to know, because when we die, and we're all going to die, and when that time comes when we're going to be with Christ forever, or we're going to be punished forever, because I know people don't like that language these days, but that's Bible. We will die and face judgment, and your soul will forever be punished, or it will forever be with God. Where will you be? That's why it's such an important question. Ransak dere selv om dere I troen. Test yourself. You don't want to lie to yourself. You don't want to be pretending, because when that day comes, you're going to want to have real faith in Christ. Prøv dere selv. Eller merke dere ikke at Jesus Kristus I dere. Bestå dere kanskje ikke prøven. Igjen, Johannes, det tre tester om hvis du frelst. Tro, bekjennelse, tester. Kjærlighet, tester. Og lydighet, tester. Vi skal ikke bli ferdige I kveld, men vi skal begynne. Og vi skal begynne å tenke. I 1 Johannes 2, kapittel 2, når Johannes han begynner å splitte folk I to forskjellige grupper. En gruppe som frelst, en gruppe som tror at de frelst, men de ikke frelst. And he splits them into two groups. And here's where the brutal language comes in, but you know, and I feel as if I can't say it, but I have to say it because it's God's word. He says, this is how you can know who belongs to Satan and who belongs to Jesus. Who are God's children and who are Satan's children? That's the language that he uses. Who has come into the light and whose eyes are still blind? Those who say, I know Jesus, but they don't know Jesus. And those who say they know Jesus and they do know Jesus. This isn't Simon Morris theology. This dead or less, Johannes Brev, you will handle how two for Shelley Grouper. Han begynner igjen Johannes 2, 20, 19. Om hvem er lygneren, om ikke den som fornekter at Jesus er Kristus. Han er antikrist, han som fornekter Faderen og Sønnen. Men dere er alle salvet av den hellige og kjenner sannheten. Jeg skriver ikke til dere fordi dere ikke kjenner sannheten, men fordi dere kjenner den og vet at ingen lygn kommer fra sannheten. Johannes 5:10. Den som tror på Guds sønn har vitnesbyrd i sitt indre. Men den som ikke tror Gud har gjort han til en løgner, for han har ikke trodd på Guds egen vitnesbyrd om sin sønn. To forskjellige grupper. Den som elsker kjærlighet, elsker sin bror, blir i lyset og fører ikke noen til fall. Men den som hater sin bror er i mørket og vandrer i mørket, han vet ikke hvor han går, for mørket har blindet øynene hans. Men det som vi vandrer i lyset, slik han selv er i lyset, da har vi fellesskap med hverandre, og blodet fra Jesus, hans sønn, renser oss for alle synd. Ser vi at vi har fellesskap med han, men vandrer i mørket, da lever vi og følger ikke sannheten. På dette vet vi at vi kjenner han, at vi holder hans bud. Den som sier, jeg kjenner han, men ikke holder hans bud, er en løgner, og sannheten er ikke i han. Alle tre er her. Konfirmasjon, kjærlighet, lydighet. En hver som tror at Jesus er Kristus er født av Gud. Og den som elsker Gud som har født oss, elsker også den som er født av han. How do you say that word? Kjennetegnet på at vi elsker Guds barn og at vi elsker Gud og holder hans bud. Og elsker Gud og holder hans bud, og hans bud er ikke tunge. For alt som er født av Gud, seirer over verden, og det som har seiret over verden, er vår tro. Og hans bud er ikke tunge. Hans bud er vakkert. Hvis du er frelst, og du leser Guds bud, Ten Commandments, kristenlivet, du er, ja, Jesus, jeg elsker det. Det er wisdom of all wisdom, Gud. Jeg skal følge deg. Jeg skal prøve det. Will you follow it perfectly? No. But there are people who say they're Christians and they look at God's commandments about alcohol, sex before marriage, words that they use, and they're like, whoo, jeg skal ikke gjøre det. Jeg vil ha mye sex før bryllup. Jeg vil ha mye alkohol. Jeg vil prøve narkotik av og til. Johannes, ikke frelst. You can't speak like that if you're born again. Like, we don't give you a weak God. God says he can give you the strength and the love to follow his ways. He will give you the strength and the love to follow his ways. Hvorfor? Ny hjerte. Bibelen i Gammelt Testament snakker om ny hjerte. Before and then after. I Jeremia 31:33, men dette er pakten jeg vil slutte med Israels hus i dager som kommer, sier Herren. Jeg legger min lov i deres synd og skriver den i deres hjerte. I deres hjerte. It's going to write it in your heart. So when you then read his laws, his commandments, you go in, yeah, vakkert. viktig. Jeg skal følge Jesus. Jeg skal følge han og hans bud. Jeg er ikke frelst av gudgjerninger, men jeg skal følge hans bud fordi jeg er frelst allerede. Ny hjerte. Jesus er vakkert. Hans bud er ikke tung. Det er vakkert. Jeg skal følge han. Jeg legger min lov i deres synd og skriver det i deres hjerte. Jeg skal være deres Gud, og de skal være mitt folk. Da skal ingen lenger undervise sin neste og sin bror og si, kjenn Herren, for de skal alle kjenne meg, både små og større, sier Herren. For jeg vil tilgi synden deres og ikke lenger huske synden. Det er fantastisk. Ikke lenger huske synden. What a great thing to be able to go to bed tonight knowing Jesus and saying, God, thank you. You do not remember my sin. Jeg har fred med deg. Forgives your sin. Forgets your sin. So amazing. Ezekiel 36:26. Jeg gir dere et nytt hjerte og en ny ånd gir inni dere. Jeg tar steinhjerte ut av kroppen deres, og gi dere et kjøtthjerte i stedet. Jeg gir min ånd i dere, og gjør at dere følger for skriftene mine, holder lovene mine, og lever etter dem. This is why in the early church, when Jesus rose from the grave, and he started showing himself to people, and they started confessing who he was, there was an explosion of Christianity throughout its culture, throughout the schools, throughout the churches, throughout the communities. It wasn't just a little bit of something maybe going on hidden. Explosion. As the Holy Spirit took over people's lives and they became Christians and they unashamedly lived the Christian life in front of other people because of the power of the Holy Spirit and a new heart and a new mind that says, hey, I'm forgiven, I'm new, I have joy, I know God, I have everlasting life, I'm living my life for him. And people started to step back and go, whoa, who are these people? Why are they living like this? Why are they speaking like this? And people gave them a name, and it wasn't a nice name. They were making fun of them. Oh, they're the Christians. They're the Christians. Why? They stood out. Like darkness and light comparison. Do we stand out? Like as a healthy challenge to us. Do we stand out in our community? Do we stand out in our schools? Or are we like the same as atheists? They don't see any difference in your language, in your clothes, in your walk, in your sexuality. No difference at all. There's got to be a difference. Right? There's got to be a difference. If God gives us a new heart, new strength, knowing him, sins forgiven, we're waking up and we're going to be different. Perfect? No. Different? Absolutely. Because I'm not going to give you a weak God, folks. I'm not going to go to, oh, you can know Jesus. Don't worry about your life. Don't worry about all the other stuff. No, when you know Jesus, he gives you the strength to live your life for him. En Johannes 3. Den som blir varende i han synder ikke. Uff. Den som synder har ikke sett han og ikke kjent han. Mine barn, la ikke noen føre det de vil. Den som gjør det som er rettferdig, slik Kristus er rettferdig. Den som gjør synd er av djevelen. Og djevelen har syndet fra begynnelsen av. Slik viser det seg hvem som er Guds barn, og hvem er djevelens barn. Den som ikke gjør det som er rett, og som ikke elsker sin bror, og ikke av Gud. Saying I believe in Jesus, it's not like just words. If I truly believe in Jesus, you will see it in my life over time. Might not be perfect, but you'll see the difference. I've been a Christian for 24 years. Have I been perfect? No. Has there been a change? Absolutely. Have I sinned less than what I used to? Absolutely. If I was here to you and say, no, I'm a Christian, 24 years, but you know, I started drinking again, and I started having lots of sex before marriage again, and but it doesn't matter because I love Jesus. Ja, jeg ikke frelst. Saved person doesn't speak like that. Can't speak like that. I'm pained by my sin. I don't like my sin when it happens. There's a struggle there now, and I go to God with it. But I enjoy living for him. I enjoy living as a Christian. I have a hope of everlasting life. Vi er snart ferdig, fordi jeg tror jeg har 50 mer bilder, men walisisk folk, vi kan snakke mye. Men jeg tror vi skal bli ferdig med bilder. Those who say they're Christians do not sin. Those who do sin are not Christians. How do we pack that out? Før vi var frelst, og jeg var frelst, det er synd her. I practiced it. I loved it. You think of juggling balls. You pick them up, you practice. I loved sex before marriage. I loved alcohol. I loved talking rude words. Sorry, girls, but in my culture, the football culture, I loved just talking about girls as just sexual objects and nothing else. Like belittling you so much to just sexuality and making fun of you with my football boys and football humor and football jokes. I loved it. But when I became a Christian, when we become Christians with the Heliond, we're now practicing righteousness. We're now practicing peace. We're now practicing joy. We're now practicing the Ten Commandments. Are we perfect? No. But do we practice? Yes. Why? Frelst. Nyarte. Fra Gud. Will I drop a ball sometimes? Yeah. But I can pick that up and go back to God. Gud, tilgi meg. Jeg frelst. I don't lose my salvation because I've sinned. I might lose my peace with God because I've sinned. But I go back to God to get, I don't go back to God asking for forgiveness to get salvation back. I have salvation. I go back to God and ask for forgiveness to get my peace with him back. Because sin for the Christian is not enjoyable. It breaks the relationship, this tension there. We practice righteousness. We practice living for Jesus. Because he's given us a new heart. See this little picture coming up by the side there? I still fight against the old man. The old Simon Morris sometimes wants to have his way again. He wants to have that sex before marriage. He wants to wear those clothes. He wants to maybe inflate his ego a bit too much. He wants to do those things. So I'm in a battle. And I'm in a battle with myself. I'm in a battle with my old nature. But we can live in victory. We can live with joy. We can live knowing God. And sometimes when we fail and we fall, we go to Jesus and we ask for forgiveness. I'm no longer practicing sin. That's what it means when we don't sin. It doesn't mean if you know Jesus, you do not sin. It doesn't mean you don't sin. But it means your attitude to sin has changed. You're in a different relationship to sin. You're not focusing on sin so much as in enjoyment because you're now too focused on practicing righteousness, glede, self-control, love, generosity, thinking of other people more than thinking about myself, practicing, knowing that every day I'm saved. I'm not practicing to be saved. I'm practicing because I am saved. Salvation is always there. And out of salvation comes this new life. Perfect? No. Different? Absolutely. Absolutely different. Back to the Mormons. Actually, not back to the Mormons. I'm going to finish on two quotes. And in theology, they always say, especially in Lutheran circles, you should never mention Calvin. But I'm Welsh, and I'm here to cause trouble. Because I'm going to mention both. Because they both say exactly the same thing about faith. We are saved by faith alone. Ichigu yaninga, I am saved by faith in Jesus' perfect work for me. I'm not saved by my good works. We are saved by faith alone, but the faith that saves is never alone. Hva betyr det? Good works will follow the saved person. You will start to live a different life for Jesus. If you're truly saved, good works will come. John Calvin, faith alone saves, but the faith that saves is never alone. So if I lived here in Sandnes, how would this work out? I'm here tonight, I've talked, I've preached, I've got my Bible, I've told you stuff. You could step back and go, gotta be a Christian. I mean, he said a lot of stuff, but how do you know? I can come here and fool you. How do you know if any of this is real? You'd be able to check me out in Sandnes, see how I live my life, see what you hear about me, see who I'm living for. And then you'll be able to go back and go, hopefully, yeah, Simon, not perfect, but he's different. Tror kan VGS, gutter og girls. They're not perfect, but they're different. Like over this next year at your school, are people going to be able to step back and hear you sing the songs, Jesus, I'm living for your name. But will they be able to step back and see you living that out every day? That you are living for his name. We've got to move away from just being Christians that sing the songs and don't live the life. Make sense? We can't just sing the songs and not live the life. We've got to sing the songs and live the life. Hvorfor? Vi har fått på ny. Vi har ny hjerte fra Jesus Kristus. Vet vi dere kjenner? We know. And Johannes, he finishes this book off by trying to remind people. And I'm going to try and remind you here tonight that you know, på dette vet vi at vi kjenner han, at vi holder hans bud. If you don't hold God's word, if you don't think God's word is beautiful, if you don't put God's word into practice in your life and you just think it's boring, in all love, you've got to step back and ask the question, am I saved? Like, do I know him? Because I don't love his commands. I don't love his ways. Like, do I know him? Because you can. You can know him. You can have everlasting life. You can have a new heart. You can have a new beginning. You can have new strength. You can, if you want it. Dere fedre, jeg skrevet til dere fordi dere kjenner han som fra begynnelsen. Ja, barn, har jeg skrevet til dere fordi dere kjenner far. Derfor vet vi at dette den siste tid. Jeg skrev ikke til dere fordi dere ikke kjenner sannheten, men fordi dere kjenner den. Nå dere vet at han rettferdig. Det 28 gang i Johannes første brev at han skriver, vi vet, vi vet, vi vet, vi vet, vi vet. We know. And again, we've got to be a generation of people, a community of people that are walking around and people just say, they know something. I don't know what it is that they know, but they know stuff. And they know it so much, they're living their lives differently. Not as individuals, because the Bible knows nothing of individual Christianity, but everything of community Christianity. Together, living this life out. We know, we know, we know, we know. And the final slide, just for us to, when we go to bed tonight, and think, okay, what does it mean to be justified by God? And if you've heard the gospel and it's never been too good to be true, forstår dere? If you've never heard the gospel, if you've heard the gospel and it's never been, wow, that is too good to be true, you've never heard the gospel. You might have heard the gospel many, many times, but if you've never stepped back and thought that is too good to be true, but it is true, then you've heard the gospel. Too good to be true, folks. It is too good to be true that God would send his son, Jesus Christ, to send a miserable sinner like me and save me from the depths of sin and darkness and despair and death and the lies of Satan. Too good to be true that he would do it. What love is this? What type of love is that? That comes for us, even though we were rebels, enemies, ungodly, haters of God. And he still stretches his hand forward in Jesus Christ and says, come to me. To be justified means this. Get this into your heart before you go to bed tonight. Når vi vet at vi frelst, vi mindre selvfokusert om mer fokusert om Gud og andre mennesker. When I'm saved, I think less of myself. I know I'm safe in God. And then I think more about God and how can other people be saved. Siste bildet. 1. Johannes 4:10. Ja, dette kjærligheten. Here's an example of love. And it's not going to be your Bible reading. It's not going to be your prayer life. It's not going to be your moral life. It's like, forget about you for a minute. Here's an example of love. Ikke at vi elsker Gud, men at han elsket oss først. Og sendt sin son til soning for våre synder. Gud, takk at du med oss. Takk at du ikke ferdig med oss. Takk at du sier at du gir oss ny hjerte. At vi kan begynne på nytt med deg. Og tilbud er vakkert. Guds vei er vakkert. Jesus har en historisk fakta. Han døde for meg, fordi foran en hellig Gud. Jeg er veldig, veldig, veldig sinnfull. Foran en hellig Gud. Jeg vet hvem jeg er. Men i evangeliet vi vet om Jesus Kristus er for oss. Så jeg ber i kveld for oss. Jeg ber for dem som vet Jesus Kristus. At igjen de kan vite han 100% og tenke ja. Gud har snakket i kveld til mitt hjerte og hjerne. Og jeg tror på han. Og jeg skal begynne med Guds kraft å leve for han. I dag, i morgen, neste dag, neste uke. Men kanskje for de som her, og de har, ja, jeg sier at jeg frelst, og jeg i kristen kommune, men jeg ikke liker hans bud, og jeg ikke liker hans vei, jeg bare tenker det er ok, og liv samme liv som atheist. Gud hjelper dem å forstå at det er mulig at de ikke har ny hjerte. Det er mulig at de ikke vet Jesus Kristus. Men de kan i kveld. Det er bare du som kan snakke til hjertet og hjerne, ikke meg. Så med Hellige Ånd Jesus snakke med folk i kveld. Hjelp oss å forstå. Hjelp oss å ha mer glede. Og hjelp oss å følge Jesus Kristus i kveld. I morgen, neste uke, neste måned, neste år, til døde og evig liv. I Jesu navn. Amen.